Once described as one of the great intellectual oases of the capital, the London Library, bastion of the poet, the novelist and the playwright for almost a century and a half, finds itself running dry, not of literary talent, but of new blood. Potential members need have just two qualifications: the ability to pay an annual fee of £70, and perhaps the most important consideration when joining a library, the ability to read, preferably without moving the lips. The members of the Committee of Management of the London Library in St James's Square deny that they are lowering standards, but reluctantly they do admit to needing the money. So, what sort of member do they want? Bamba Gascoigne is a management committee member.
It was a sort of private club. Now anyone can join just by paying their £70. And of course it is a lot of money, but it nowadays is only, what, 9 or 10 novels, so to speak. And here are 1 million books at everybody's disposal in which you can browse and take straight home. It's like having a massive private library of one's own, in which instead of just taking the books from the shelf into one's armchair direct, you do put them in the car or the tube in between. But it is our own private library for each member, which is astonishing. 1 million books in the last... Everything of importance in the last century and a half is here for us to be picked off the shelf and looked at.
Membership fees and investments bring in £500,000 a year. It costs just a few pounds less than that to run the library. So if it's to survive, it'll need to stop its membership dwindling below its present level of 6,000. Colin Baker in St James's Square.